Girish asks if he should sell long-term debt funds since he believes that these days they seem to carry both interest rate risk as well as credit risk because funds have been investing in lower rated bonds.
Yes, I would say that, you know, it's always a good idea to be a little more conservative with your bond funds because the risk return equation is very unfavorable for investor. For the sake of 1% higher return or, you know, 2% higher return on an annual basis, thinking of, you know, or taking a chance with, you know, 3% depletion in capital, because mutual funds are very risky when it comes to long-term debt funds because of their design. Sometimes the risk arises because if the fund is faced with poor credit and poor credit defaults, or there is some kind of deep repayment crisis, or even on a small part of the portfolio, what happens is it scares many investors. Investors act in haste and, you know, take a lot of money out, and that becomes the primary risk. When many investors pull their money out from bond fund, the fund faces a crisis, and that translates into a big risk for many investors. So for a marginally higher return, putting at stake a marginal decline in value of your investment is not worthwhile. Be conservative with your investment, and from that standpoint, given the current scenario, I would say that long-term debt fund always will turn out to be more volatile. There is another reason why long-term debt funds will prove to be extremely volatile, and that is also because of the design, the way mutual funds are designed, and the liquidity of the underlying investment. When it comes to corporate debt and other things, you know, they are short maturity papers. You know, you rarely come across 5 years or more term for such corporate debt. But when it comes to long maturity papers, there are the only option for fund managers is to invest in Government of India bonds. Government of India bonds being very liquid, and there is a larger market for them because every bank is supposed to invest in them. It is also a kind of mandatory investment mandated by the RBI for compliance reason for their SLR, CRR needs. And their solvency needs forces banks to, so there is a larger market. So whenever there is a change in the interest rate outlook, the price changes very quickly. And changing dynamics of, or your changing outlook of interest rate has a big bearing. And so long maturity bond funds tend to be far more volatile because the underlying market is far more liquid. Other bond funds are less volatile and they are artificially less volatile because the price is not discovered in as efficient a manner, because most of those instruments are valued on YTM or based on the valuation matrix which is used by the mutual fund companies for arriving at the less these bonds, the corporate bonds, which are not liquid at all.